When you join a Teams meeting, there are certain things you need to do in advance, and you've probably gotten good at doing them by now. For example, figuring out how to connect your camera and your microphone, how to activate and deactivate your video and put yourself on mute, where to find chat, and all these things that go with these online meetings. But there are still some embarrassing mistakes that can happen. So let's go through them. Number one, overwriting shared files without knowing. So you've been invited to a meeting. Now this meeting has a file. You open it beforehand to take a look. Then you go grab a coffee, come back, and you start thinking about your salary and you type in some scenarios for possible salary increase. And then you realize you're using the file that was supposed to be for the meeting. Well, no problem. You are just going to close it without saving. Later, when you see your salary during the meeting, you realize you never got prompted to save that file. That's because files in Teams are online files. So when you use Excel or Word, you're using the web version. Everything is automatically saved. Even if you go and remove that information, it could be traced back to you. What you'd want to do is open version history and restore the original or the previous version before you made your change. To get to version history, go to File, Info, Version History. You can see the version on the side. You'll have groupings if a lot of changes were made all at once. Find the version you want to go back to and restore. The great thing is you see the changes by username, so that helps in finding the right version to restore. This automatic saving isn't just for meeting files, it's for any file you use in Teams. If you want to make sure that you don't unintentionally change something, change your view up here to viewing instead of editing. Mistake number two, echo during meeting calls. The best way to avoid echo during a meeting is to use headphones. You should also have your audio on mute anytime you're not speaking. The shortcut key for this is Ctrl+Shift+M. This is anyhow good practice because you don't want your conversation with your roommates to be broadcasted. What are you watching? I wish our stuff was as exciting. It's the same boring stuff every week. Don't worry, I'm on mute. Did I use the wrong shortcut? If you're presenting and you have a second device that you're logged into the same meeting because you're using it to check the viewer experience, which is something I often do, make sure that you're on mute there as well and the audio is turned off on your second device, so no sound is being broadcasted. Mistake number three, your camera is on and you forgot about it. If you're the presenter and you're sharing your desktop, you currently don't see your video being streamed. It's tempting to forget that you're still on camera. So if you don't really need to be on camera, turn off your video. This way, you can concentrate on the presentation and not have to worry so much about your body language. If you're a participant, it's also important to remember that your camera is on. Now, at the beginning, we're aware of that, but as the meeting goes on, we tend to forget. You might not see yourself on the bar at the bottom, but this doesn't mean that others can't see you. So keep this in mind when you're in a meeting. Mistake number four is showing people things they can't see. In a team meeting, you can share your desktop, a window, or a PowerPoint presentation. Now, a lot of the time, people choose to share a window instead of desktop because they don't want to show everything that's popping up on their screen. Now, the downside of sharing a specific window is that not everything might be visible to your audience. For example, if I'm sharing an Excel file and I go to the conditional formatting dialog box here and I start talking about this, people are going to be confused. If they don't know the application, they might not even know that they're missing something. So if you're doing a product demo, you'd want to be sure that they see everything. If you share desktop, you're going to be on the safer side because this way you know that all the other dialog boxes are going to be visible. What you can do to be also sure that everyone can see what you can see is to have a second device which you can use to join the meeting with again. So you join the same meeting with the same credentials just a second time. Make sure that you're only presenting though on one device and that you have your audio and video off on the second device. This way you can keep an eye on chat and also make sure that your audience is seeing everything that you're seeing. Okay, so these are four common mistakes that I've seen often in my past team meetings. Do you have some mistakes that you've come across? Please share this with us below. Thank you for watching. If you aren't subscribed to this channel and you like the content here, make sure you subscribe before you leave. I'm going to see you in the next video.